This week at NASA.
4, 3, 2, 1, fire.
NASA's next generation 5-segment solid rocket development motor, or DM2, was fired in its test stand at ATK's facility in Promontory, Utah. The successful cold motor test was completed in less than 3 minutes and was designed to advance the understanding, safety, technology, and capability of solid rocket motors. The DM2's overall temperature was lowered to 40 degrees Fahrenheit to validate the motor's performance in cold weather, in contrast to the DM1 testing, which was conducted at ambient temperature.
This was a cold test, which is one of the most severe and tough environments for a solid rocket motor to undergo. And it looks like the motor performed brilliantly.
The DM2 motor, which is capable of producing 22 million horsepower and generating as much as 3.6 million pounds of thrust, was developed by ATK Space Systems. NASA's Chief Technologist, Bobby Braun, made several stops on his agency-wide tour, visiting various facilities at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, the Glenn Research Center, and Dryden Flight Research Center. Braun was shown some of the cutting-edge technologies in development at each center. Braun told employees that NASA is moving back to its roots and its three interrelated core competencies.
When I think about NASA, I think really about three things. One, research and technology. Two, flight systems, flight hardware and software. Flight systems, and three, mission operations.
All 10 programs under the Office of Chief Technologist are designed to take ideas from basic concept to the working prototype or testing phase, then use them in applicable projects and missions. And now, centerpieces.
The Magnetospheric Multiscale Mission, MMS, has passed its critical design review. The mission consists of 4 identical satellites that will orbit in formation to study reconnection in Earth's magnetic fields. Reconnection is a universal process that taps energy stored in magnetic fields and converts it explosively to heat and energy. Reconnection affects important technologies such as power grids, communication, and navigation. The data MMS collects will help scientists better understand reconnection events in order to protect our electronic infrastructure. Goddard engineers will build and monitor the 4 satellites used in the MMS mission. The MMS satellites are scheduled for launch in 2014.
To the sounds of shovels and cheers, the Glenn Research Center broke ground for a 93,000 square foot structure that'll become Glenn's new centralized office building. The 3-story space will be U.S. Green Building LEED Silver certified. Will house 300 workers and include open work areas, conference rooms, a conferencing center, and a 400-seat auditorium.
This is the first new office building here on the Glenn main campus in over 20 years. And it really represents the start of the master plan that we had approved back in 2007.
The LEED certification program is a nationally accepted benchmark for the design, construction, and operation of high-performance green buildings. Friends and families of the slumbering STS-132 astronauts picked the songs that woke them up last May. Now NASA wants you to take over its morning show DJ duties. With the Wake Up Song Contest, you can help choose the morning music for the last 2 scheduled space shuttle missions. Pick your favorite from a list of 40 previously played songs or submit an original space-themed composition. The 2 Wake Up Songs with the most votes will be played during STS-133 and 134. To cast your vote or submit a song, visit https://songcontest.nasa.gov. The STS-133 astronauts are scheduled to launch aboard Space Shuttle Discovery on November 1st. STS-134 crew members are targeted for February 26, 2011, to launch aboard Endeavour for the International Space Station on the last Space Shuttle flight. A little girl with a big heart has given NASA centers a run for their money during the Fed Feeds Families food drive. 12-year-old Layla Aminian, whose mother, Roya Mayer, works for NASA's Independent Validation and Verification Facility, IV&V, in Fairmont, West Virginia, donated more than a ton of food from her community, 967 pounds of it in July. If Layla was a NASA center, that would have put her in sixth place for the month.
I got cans from my neighborhood, not only, and I got money. And then I also got coins around my house. And I got money from my uncles and aunts and family. And my dad's colleagues and my mom's friends and like a lot of people. And I sold snow cones in my neighborhood at our pool.
She's done a phenomenal job. This is an amazing amount of food, as you can see here in the truck, for just one little girl to collect here in West Virginia.
With funds she collected from friends, family, and neighbors, Layla purchased another 1,000-plus pounds of food in August. The Fed Feeds Families drive supports food banks across the country. The winning center will be announced later this month. And that's This Week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, log on to www.nasa.gov.